Start. This appeal is directed against the judgment and order dated 13-9-2007, passed by the High Court of Judicature at Bombay in Central, Excise Appeal Number 327 of 2006, full stop. Briefly stated, comma, the appellant is engaged in manufacturer of cotton and man-made fabrics, full stop. According to the appellant, comma, the fabric manufactured by the appellant was not amenable to excise duty since it was for captive consumption and not to be removed from the purposes of sale or for consumption as envisaged under Rule 9, read with Rule 49 of the Central Excise Rules 1944, bracket open, for short, the rules, bracket close, full stop. On this assertion and relying on the decision of the High Court of Delhi in J.K. Cotton Spinning and Weaving Mills Company Limited and others versus Union of India and others, the appellant filed two writ petitions under Article 226 of the Constitution of India before the High Court of Delhi, being civil writ petition numbers 1234 of 1981 and 1235 of 1981, full stop. The reliefs claimed in both petitions are identical, except that they pertain to separate periods, full stop. We may reproduce the reliefs claimed in writ petition number 1235 of 1981, comma, for the sake of convenience, full stop. The same read thus, full stop, para. Issue a suitable writ, comma, order or direction declaring that duty of excise is not payable in respect of yarn, cotton and man-made processed further in the petitioner's composite mills in the manufacture of fabrics, full stop, para. Issue writ of certiorari or any other suitable writ, comma, order or direction in the nature thereof quashing and setting aside the decisions and directives of the Central Board of Excise, comma, respondent number 2, comma, contained in circular letters dated 6-10-1976, 24-9-1980 and to quash the notices dated 23-4-1981 and all similar notices referred to in the statement, comma, dated 7-1-1981 and dated 9-3-1981, full stop, para. Issue a writ of mandamus or any other appropriate writ, comma, order of direction in the nature thereof, comma, restraining the respondents from levying or collecting duty of excise in respect of yarn obtained by the petitioner at an intermediary stage in its composite mill for further processing in the manufacture of fabrics and to direct the board, comma, respondent number 2, comma, to cancel and oblique or withdraw the decisions and directives contained in circular letters dated 6-10-1976, Annexure A, and 24-9-80, and to direct respondent 3 and 4 to cancel and oblique or withdraw the notice dated 23-4-1981, 23-2-81, and all similar notices referred to in the statement, comma, dated 7-1-1981 and 9-3-1981, and to restrain defendants 3 and 4 from taking any steps or oblique proceedings pursuant to and in accordance with the aforesaid directives and notices. Full stop para. It is a pleasure to receive the delegation of diplomat trainees from Bangladesh led by the rector and the director general of the Bangladesh Foreign Service Academy. Full stop. Bangladesh is special for us. Full stop. Therefore, comma, your visit to India is also special. Full stop para. I am happy to know that this is the fourth training course for diplomat trainees being conducted by FSI. Full stop. I recall the visit of the previous batch of officer trainees to Uparashtrapati Bhavan in November 2018. Full stop. I understand that you have an intense 2 weeks program in India. Full stop. The sessions at FSI in the second week would give you an overview on India's foreign policy. Full stop para. I am glad to know that in addition to India's political system, comma, cultural diplomacy and soft power projection, comma, you have also called on the governor of West Bengal and visited the Rashtrapati Bhavan, comma, the Election Commission of India, Shantiniketan, comma, Vishwa Bharati, comma, Elephanta Caves, comma, National Gallery of Modern Art, comma, Exim Bank and Bombay Stock Exchange. Full stop para. I am also informed that your India visit, comma, unlike those for other training courses by FSI, would cover 5 cities, comma, which again is in line with the unique nature of ties between India and Bangladesh. Full stop. I am sure that you will return to Bangladesh with a much deeper understanding of India. Full stop para. India attaches the highest importance to bilateral relations with Bangladesh. Full stop. We always believe that a strong, comma, stable and prosperous Bangladesh is India's interest, and we would like to be a partner in your journey of progress to become a developed country by 2041. Full stop para. We reaffirm our commitment to stand with Bangladesh as a modern, secular, prosperous, soaring state in keeping with the spirit of 1971 and in line with the vision of Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman and Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina for a developed Bangladesh.